I'm making the horse pay attention to my seat and give me his concentration without having to poke prod him or pick him up. But as you can see, the first few circles I walked round, I was losing. He was like so focused on the cows, and I was just like passing the weight to see what's going to happen next. And now, so can I make him carry me from the end of the rein? I've just got a key saying you've got to preserve the contact, and if you're not going to be nice at the end of the rein where you're munching, I'm just going to drop the rein, so you can't munch on it. But every time you move your neck, I'm just going to give you a little tweak down the rein to say don't move, and it's just going to, with this walk and that going on, it's going to relax. Obviously this isn't a walking this is, I use this an awful lot with our age because these guys have got the ability to tense the back amazing. So now my bottom is just pushing as if I'm pushing the swing faster, and I'm slowly increasing the walk. I'm going to see what happens. If he starts to tense, chew on the bit, lean on the forehand, I'll slow him back down again. So we're building the walk. Squeeze, pumps my shoulders to sit up back, and it's with me. So now I'm still in the room. Two cups of coffee, this is it, you don't spill the drink, you can do your heart pulse. Monitoring the water all the time. Good boy.
Good boy.
Good boy.
So I'd give him a little
tiny, not a smallest little thing. Just makes him put his water underneath a little bit. Doesn't hurt him.
Whoa.
Good. And I'm riding on a circle makes every stride you say. So I get to monitor what this horse is doing underneath me every single stride. Before I allow him to go large and then go straight in my bed, and then straight in my bed down the long side. So, let's see what we've got. So again, this balance in my hand is just beautiful. I feel like he's holding my hand like you're holding Lucas. I can drop it if I like.
His ears are moving around, it's really beautiful.
So, as you know, this horse is a stressor, isn't it?
Oh my god, oh my god!
If you ride them, this is what you've got to do with the Zapana and Andalusia. If you've really got to be sensitive and ride them with care. A little half old and you've been bitten by a wobbly hand, he's going to worry about
me. Oh, what does she mean? What is all? Yeah. I've got it wrong, I've got it wrong.
You know, they just want to please you so much. So,
thank you.
It makes a lot of anger in just turn. pulling off, you pull your left leg, both legs, push in, bang.
Yeah.
Yeah?
So the direction you want to go.
Exactly, my leg. So when I turn to this leg, push. Yeah. And then when you start, is to concentrate.
Never mind, you're away.
Okay, so don't start. Because if he's munching on the bridle, don't hold his mouth. Make him just go there and just keep turning him in. Let's put you on board now. Let's see if I can get you to feel the connection. I've stolen your lesson now.
No, it's okay. This is what we want. Oh.
Nice and warm now. Also, your saddle is amazing, but it's as slippy as a slide.
Yeah.
So when I kind of like to go all squashy and feel the horse with all my body, I'm like, whoosh, like swimming. What you need to buy is some Carindate leather balm. Every time you get on, put it on. And just leave it for the night, and that's it. You don't have to drink it, just put it on. And it will make it feel like sticky, not sticky, but you know, like, you can't stroke it, it's sticky. And then you won't like feel like surfing.
Well done, baby.
Be sure to set your mind is like more more bossy on the right there.
I didn't get that.
Did you not?
Not at all.
Not at all. She felt absolutely perfect. So, he didn't have one that felt worse than the other. Let me feel, I did only ride one. Just hold your horses. Right. Hold your reins. So, contact. Keep your hands still. Is that? Okay, that's good. That's what we need to tune into. That's it. Okay. When he's not there, just hug a little bit. Vibrations. Okay. And that's your vibrations. Really, what he does is he tends to come to you straight away, doesn't it? So if I was just to follow just with the vibrations here, you should just follow my hand and go into the body.
Yeah.
There you go. Okay. So you get your contact. Now a little walk. You feel he's leaning down. I want to think there's a little button near here that you can. Your hands put short up here, just a little deeper. God, it's just fingers. Just going to work it all. You can still work your fingers out. So, space here. Carry the baby, but just squeeze my fingers. Sit. So, you keep the contact now squeezed. And then just squeeze. So, my feet are like, do it. So don't pull your hands on the glute because it's just the only way to feel each other's hand and you're just talking to you. If you move your hand, you then can't feel what the horse is feeling. Okay. Watch me. want him to come a little bit round, just out the legs. That's it, there. So bend your shoulder. We'll stop you doing this. Okay, so, yeah, you're more tight in the heel, the both reins equal, and higher. Yeah. Hands need to be up because that's where you're more sensitive. With your bottom, slow down your bottom, sit heavier on your bottom and reach the top of your boots. Sit heavier, sit back. So stop pushing the saddle faster, sit heavy against it. Feel like your tummy stops there. Get a little tweaking. Now don't hold it on the forehand, it's going to come to this with your bottom body. Sit back, yeah, we'll tweak that remains to stay balanced. Yeah, still even half this speed again. Outside main control straight. Yeah, and feel like you can now do a bungee squeeze on one leg and drop the leg. Squeeze the bungee, let it go. Squeeze the bungee, let it go. Yeah, how good is that? And you can drop the leg, hopefully. Yeah, that's not like what's this. What you know, like I did, and I went like that. Yeah, he pulled the leg and you drop it in his mouth, not in your hand. So just drop your reins again, get the contact. Good. Round it, little tweak, sit back, two legs in chair, yeah, that feeling, you feel your tummy muscles pulling,
yeah,
that's a good feeling, okay, open your hands wider, and just hug him a little louder, that's it, hug out, so hold me just tighter, there, yeah, balance, now sit against your floor, that's it, push it, yeah, yeah, balance it, little short of your bend. Yeah, they just want your arms to be longer and your brain to be shorter, but not the contact stronger. Yeah, still up. Even still up. Don't kick him, just on top of your boots. Yeah, right. Now, without kicking him, sit back still. Now push your saddle. So I want the horse to feel the saddle moving and it's going to walk faster. Stop in the rain, bring him below. Tweak, tweak to keep him round. Pushing the seat, pushing the seat, pushing the seat. You need longer strides because you're going push, push, push with the saddle. You need longer strides. Make the feeling that you want to do it. On the long, long, yeah. Open your little head. Yeah, good. That's it. That's a nice and warm. Now again, little leg, leg. Don't lean forward when you leg in. Yeah. What I want you to do when you put your leg on, leg and push your seat at the same time. So what you naturally did is you went forward.
Yeah.
So your seat, remember he can't feel your shoulders, but he can feel the weight in your seat. So if you push the saddle forward, it says, oh, I need to give you the width. So you're going to stay. Half hold down, Yes. If you kick him and keep hold of the front end, he can't go anywhere. So then he comes back like a sewing machine. Okay, so you just got to have him really round. And then as you push the hand forward, just give him a little touch with the wrist. Give him a little touch. You're not hitting it. Yeah, you feel it?
Yeah.
Now go large. Hold hands with his mouth. Hold hands. Yes. Beautiful. And need your arms a little bit shorter. Don't change the feel down the rainbow, but can you shorten them? Yeah, so hands in front of you. A bit more than that, inch on your toes, still more. Down the rainbow. That's good. That's better. Hands up. Stay back on your shoulders. Yes. Now then, little squeeze. Would you squeeze the inside leg? Then soften it, and then you can tap as you soften it. Squeeze it. Push it away. Tap, tap. Yeah, again. Yeah, that was better. And again, little squeeze at the tap. Oh, you feel them taking it?
Yeah.
So what we need to do is we need to, this horse needs lots of bringing back to creepy crawl around in the trot, sending forward to strengthen up that little bit of a weave which has got in that right here.
Yeah.
Okay, a little bit around there. There. Now, slow down without using your legs. Just slow your bottom. If he leans on you, speak up. Just stare a little, as if you're squeezing your punches to your shoulders. Oh, slow, even slow. Don't ride as high as the saddle. Catch him. Open your hands out, with your front of your head up. You've got to catch him, that's it. Yeah, open your head up. Yeah, good. Keep him right in the top. You want to save one or the other bit of it. Open hand. Yeah, catch him. Leading your heart this speed now. Raise it on long again. So your veins are going to give you that feeling that you're pushing your really heavy wheelbarrow. So as you go down alongside, I can always tell you're holding, not the horse, you're holding your left rein more than your right one. Everybody that has a leaning rein always carries it longer. Because it's naturally easier for the body to have the rein nearer to the leaning. So open your hand and just squeeze out, wide your hand, little tweak, wide your hand, little tweak. Yes! Now pushing forward again. Now don't just go bang go. Every stride a bit more. Push the hand forward, a bit more. Gotta feel when you ask me to go forward that you soften the rein to say, go on, the door is open, you can go forward. Yeah, if you keep holding it, he's gonna think you out. Tap his bottom, high up on your bottom. Very top and bottom, yeah. You've got to get even higher than that. Open hands wide. Good, hands out, hold, catch it, same way as you put in the walk, open out wide. Yeah, now tap, soften the rein and go. Yeah, good boy. So keep your hand out around the corner, you need to slow down. So now this corner, give it a little more hold, soften the rein and tap, go. Yeah, open out, catch it. Okay, good, well done. So do that again. So if he puts his head up, just move to your veins and catch him to go up. Right up there. Well done, mate. Oh, more. Put it back. Just pop over and just start to the veins. Back to the top. There you go. Ready? Half hold. Go. Open hands. Do it again. Half hold. Go. Yeah, good boy. And again, let's pop up out and then give the vein away. Tap. One more. Keep training them though. You don't give them anything to think about. They start sort of seeing
I see dead bodies.
Yeah.
I start seeing the world.
Outside.
The cows or something other than work.
Below.
The room at the top of it.
Yeah. Well, she was on that also, was she?
2 years.
Oh.
Including both 2 years before I got home.
I don't
know. Well, then I had him put some
on the floor. Oh,
okay. But he still thinks he's
Australian. Right, I can do it for her. I would think that it
is.
Right, so let's have a look at him. So, did you go to Port Deal again, Dave?